Hello everyone and welcome to this course on Python Programming Basic Fundamentals. Now in this course we will be covering the basics of Python, and when I'm saying basics of Python, these are the basics which are going to help you in lot of things. For example, if you want to prepare for your preparations, if you want to prepare for your university examinations, or maybe if you want to prepare for machine learning or applied AI kind of courses, so these fundamentals are going to be very helpful for you. For this entire video classes, we will be using the reference materials, and the link of the reference material is given on the slide in front of you. So most of the examples that we will be taking are from this particular reference materials, and these are official reference materials only. We will be doing the explanations in as simple as possible, because we want every one of you to understand Python, and Python is so easy to learn, it will not take you more than maybe 5 or 10 hours to complete the entire Python programming tutorials here from these videos, because Python is one of the very easiest and easy to learn programming language, and very powerful as well. And along with the course, we will be doing some of the mini projects, and these mini projects are going to help you for maybe your college examinations, or maybe for your job preparation. These mini projects are going to be very helpful for you. And then we will be taking some competitive programming problems in this course, which are very useful for placement preparation. And after we finish this course, we will be doing some of the courses for machine learning. So what is Python? So as you can see, Python is a very easy to learn, powerful programming language. And when I'm saying easy to learn, trust me, it is one of the most easiest programming language that you can ever come across. It is much easier as compared to C and C++. It has very efficient high level data structures and a very simple but effective approach to object oriented programming. And it is one of the ideal language for scripting and rapid application development, which is also called as RAD in some of the cases. And it is the ideal language for machine learning and AI implementation. Now Python is an interpreted language. What do you mean by interpreted language? If you see the programs like C and C++, to run the program you have to compile it completely. So entire program, all the libraries will be compiled before giving the output. But here in Python you see every single line, every single script can be executed differently, which makes it very easy. If you want to do testing in the program, if you want to create rapid programs, it is very easy when the programming language itself is interpreted. So what do you mean by interpreted language? I'll create a separate language lecture for this, which will be very helpful for you to understand what is the difference between the interpreted language and what is the difference between normal compiled language, which is like C and C++. And the Python enables programs to be written compactly and readably. Compactly means you just to write a simple work, I mean if you want to solve a problem using Python, the program will be very short and they will be very crisp, because there are already inbuilt data structures that are already present. There are many functions and libraries that are already present in Python, which makes it very easy to implement such problem solving using Python. And this Python programs are typically very short as compared to the programs in C and C++, because of the various reasons, as I said, because here you see the high level data structures, which are very complex data structures, they are implemented with the very simple functions, already inbuilt functions in Python, and it's very easy to use the power of those data structures while solving problem. And here we do not have to use indentations. We don't have to use brackets to group the statements. So here the grouping of the statements is done by indentation instead of using the opening as well as the closing bracket here in Python, which makes it very easy to program, because you don't have to take care of where is the opening bracket, where is the closing bracket in case of. And the third is, in case of Python, variables and argument declarations are not necessary. If you see in case of your C and C++ programming language, or in case of Java and .NET, in all these programming languages, before using a variable you have to declare that a particular there's a variable, it is of type integer or character or float, and then you have to use it. But in case of Python, the variable declaration is not at all necessary. Without even declaring the variable, you can create it and you can use it, which makes it very easy while programming. And why the name Python? So Python is it does not mean that Python is a snake here. Python, this name is given from a BBC show, which is Monty Python's Flying Circus, and from that entire name, they have taken the word Python to name this programming language. Thank you.